If you are just getting started with Facebook and Instagram advertising, or you want to get serious about it with optimizing your ad sets, then you're going to need to install the Facebook pixel. That's what this video is all about. So let's get into it. Now, I know for most of you that a short video is a good video. So I'll get in early and say, if you enjoy the content of my channel, please go ahead and click the like button, click subscribe. I'm going to jump on the computer in just a second, but I just want to explain exactly what the Facebook pixel is. Basically, the Facebook pixel allows you to introduce additional optimization to your Facebook and Instagram ads. It also allows you to collect custom audiences at the same time. It's a piece of code that you install on your website or your landing page, and that code executes JavaScript, which sends data back to Facebook about what people are doing on your website, whether they are visiting web pages, adding items to their shopping cart, checking out, completing their purchase. Facebook then collects that data and it creates events from there. Now, some of those events are automatically created in some systems. Some of them will be custom events that you'll need to configure within Facebook. Then you can take those events and you can configure your ad sets so that they are optimized for that particular event. If you're collecting information about people who are purchasing from your website, then you can optimize the ad set in your conversion campaign so that you are asking Facebook, find me more people who will complete this particular event, i.e. purchase. It'll examine the data about the people who have purchased and go and find more for it. That's pretty much how it works. The other thing that it does is it allows you to create audiences around certain events. So if you wanted to create an audience, say for people who have visited a particular category page or a particular product page, or if you wanted to create a audience for people who have opted in for a lead magnet and then they've gone to the download page for your lead magnet and you want to find more people who actually make it that far, then you can create custom conversion events around that. What I'm going to show you is how you install the Facebook pixel. I'm not going to show you how you can set up your Facebook business manager. I've already got videos for that. It's just about installing the Facebook pixel today. So let's jump onto the computer. So here we are in the Facebook business manager. If you don't already have a Facebook business manager set up, then I have another video on how you do that and how you set up your first ad account. There'll be a link to that in the description below. What you need to do once you're in there is go to the hamburger icon and then click on events manager. As you can see, I've created this dummy business manager and Facebook account. I have no data sources configured. So you just hover over the plus button and you click on connect data sources. For most of you, it's going to be your website. So you select that one and then you click connect. Now I'll have the conversions API connection and configuration in another video. Today, we're just going to worry about the Facebook pixel only. So we'll select that one and then go connect. Then we click on continue and we'll give the pixel a name. I suggest that you use something that can be associated back to your business, especially if you're an agency and you're helping a client set this up so that it's easy for you to tell different pixels from each other. If you are running a common platform like Shopify for e-commerce, or you might be running ClickFunnels or one of those, you can have a go at doing the easy setup options. I'm running mine on high level, so I know this isn't going to work. Then you just click connect. Now I'm going to show you how to install the code manually. Then I'll talk a little bit about how you install it on other platforms too. You click on copy code. If you were to install that to something like ClickFunnels, which requires you to install it to the header of the website, you would go into your ClickFunnels page. So you'd edit the page. This is an example that's provided by ClickFunnels. You click on settings, then click on tracking code, click on header code, and then you paste in the Facebook pixel code. Then you click on save and you are done. And once you've installed that code, and you click on continue. Turning on automatic advanced matching is something that you definitely want to do. It's a relatively new feature from Facebook. So we'll turn that on. Basically that would try to capture other details about people so that it can match them up more easily on Facebook. Since iOS 14, there are people who are on Apple iPhone or other Apple devices who aren't sharing data with Facebook. Not many of these data points you'll be able to collect, but you want to turn that on anyway, which will improve the performance of your matching. And you click on continue. Then at this point, you can then test the installation of your pixel with the event setup tool. Now I'm not going to go through that today. I will show you how to make sure that your pixel is actually installed using Pixel Helper. But firstly, I just want to talk about how you can install the pixel on other platforms where you don't need to actually manually install the code. So before I do that, I'm going to grab my pixel ID. So if I go to data sources from the events manager, I've got the pixel here. If you click on settings, then this is the pixel ID. So if you just click on that, it'll copy that to your clipboard and you can go over to whatever system you want to install the pixel to. If you've got Shopify, you just need to go into the Shopify backend, click on sales channels and then Facebook, and then you click on continue setup under Facebook marketing. It's going to ask you for the pixel ID and you'll have to connect to the ad account and then the Facebook page. Then it'll go from there and ask you to add in a catalog. For WooCommerce, you've also got a default integration for the Facebook pixel, which you can use. I tend to use one called Pixel Your Site, which is a different add-on that also includes an integration with the Facebook Conversions API, and it works really well. It's very configurable and the free one does everything you need it to do. If you're using another system like Wix, then that is also just going to ask you for the pixel ID. It'll connect your Facebook account and the ad account with the pixel on the Wix side of things, and then it'll start passing data back and forth. So once you've got your pixel installed, how do you test it? Make sure it works okay. The simple way just to make sure that it's been installed okay is to use something called the Facebook Pixel Helper. Now that is a Chrome plugin. You can also install it into Microsoft Edge. So if you just search for Pixel Helper Chrome, you'll see it right there. You just need to go ahead and install that. Once it's installed, you'll be able to see this little icon here. And if you select that, it will show you that there's a pixel installed and the pixel ID. It may also show some events that are already firing. So we can see we've got this page view event that's fired there. So how does this look from an e-commerce perspective? I'll just go over to my friend Nathan's website at costumes.com.au. If you click the pixel icon there, you can see that he's got a pixel installed. If we just jump onto a product page, you can see we get a little bit more detail of view content. Event's been fired. Now, if we add to cart, you can see that we've got an add to cart event that's been fired. So with most e-commerce platforms, there's a bunch of default events that'll be configured as soon as you install the pixel integration. And they'll usually include events like page view, view content, add to cart, start a checkout and purchase by default. You can add in other custom events as well if you need more than the ones that are already built into the integration. So did you get your pixel installed? Hopefully you did. If you have any other questions, just drop them in the comments below and I'll answer those. I do respond to all the comments on my YouTube videos at this stage. If you enjoyed this content, you found it useful, go ahead, smash on the like button, click subscribe. I really appreciate that. And before you go, I want to let you know that my agency is a specialized Instagram and Facebook advertising agency. We help people configure, install, set up, tweak, get better with Facebook and Instagram advertising. If you are thinking about getting started with Facebook and Instagram ads, or you are wanting to do better than what you are already doing, and your budget is at least $100 per day, and you want to talk to somebody about how you can do better or get going, there'll be a link in the video description below. You can click on that and go ahead and book a time in my calendar or one of my team and have a chat with us about that. We can talk to you about what you're doing in your business, what you're wanting to do, how the pricing works, all that good stuff. Maybe we'll end up working together. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.